Good evening. I want to thank JDBC for inviting me to speak on raising capital. I'm going to be speaking on raising capital through the Jamaica stock market. First of all, though, I want to see the hands of those, anybody who knows about the stock exchange. Okay, it's a good showing from the number of persons here. And really, what I want to do is just tell you about the role of the exchange first, and then speak to raising of capital through the exchange. So the exchange is there to provide investors. The exchange operates markets. And we all know what markets do. It's where buyers and sellers meet, as simple as that. It's where buyers and sellers meet, and in this case, is where buyers and sellers meet in respect to money. Right? Some persons want money, and the other persons have the money to give them. Simple as that, where buyers and sellers meet. No mystery about it. And so you have businesses who want to get funds. So one of the role of the exchange is to operate a market so that persons can get funds to grow their business. It also operates a market where you can pass capital on efficiently and fairly. Persons know what is happening. You know, there's no mystery about what is happening. And it provides an option for financing. Now, there are different ways in which, as business persons, you can get money to grow your business. And the typical way, that's the next slide, the typical way is through debt, where you go and borrow, and you may borrow from the bank. The other way that you can do it is if you get friends, families, or other persons interested in your business. And when that is done, you call it equity financing. But it's really persons having a share, an ownership in your business. Now, what are the properties of debt financing? When you go, as all of us, I'm sure you know, when you go to the bank and you borrow, you have to pay interest on the money. And usually there is no time given to you in which to start paying that interest. The clock starts to tick right away. And usually you have to have what we call security. The bank normally asks you what you have in order to ensure that they can be paid, or if they are not paid, then what they can claim in order to get back their money. And so nothing is wrong with debt financing, but you must know how you are getting involved with that and how you can pay back those money. You must know that you are going to be paying interest and the clock starts to tick right away. Now there is the other element, which is called equity financing. And equity financing, as I say, it's really having persons, inviting persons to have a share, a part of your business. So they share in the profit, they share in the losses. And there is, when you do equity financing, there's always a better chance that there is long-term viability, or your business will continue to be around for a long time. And with equity financing, again, you need no collateral, no assets. Now, there are some ways that you can do equity financing. And this is private, and I'll come to the stock exchange in a minute. Private, and that's through your family, your friends, and most persons here, their companies, if you have a company, it's probably a private company, private limited company. But there is another way that you can get it, and it is through the public in general. And if you invite the public in general, it's not automatic that that company, if it's a public company, that is going to be listed on an exchange. It's not automatic, but what happens is that most persons would readily give you money and be a part owner of the company if they feel that that company's stocks are going to be listed on the exchange. Because what that means is, if you become an owner in the business and you want to sell those stocks, you are not inhibited from doing so because you have a market, which is a stock market, where buyers and sellers meet. And this is what we call a secondary market, so that persons will be able to sell the stocks, or if you want to buy more, then you can buy more. The process, however, is not a process that does not require some work. It requires work to get monies from the general public. It is important that companies such as yours, you are looking to raise more capital. It is important that your books and records are kept in a good manner. It is important that you have a business plan. You know where you are going. And I know that there are JDBC actually help with that. So the fact is that you need to get your house, so to speak, in order to raise money from the general public. Now, one of the reasons you would be thinking of going the route of equity financing, going the route of persons having more shares in your business, being a part of your business, is that you want the breathing space. When you ask persons to be involved, to be shareholders, it is called patient capital. It's patient because you don't, as a shareholder, demand right away to get payment from the monies that you have now put in the business. Just as when you have a business and you invite friends, they are not going to be expecting to get probably something back right away. They're waiting until the business do well. So it is in the same way with equity financing. It is patient capital. Eventually, if the business does well, what you'll have is dividend payment. You might have bonus on your stocks, meaning you get a stock split or you get a bonus. So it is, you have to time that business. If you want to grow, if you want to expand, you have the business already, you might have some loan, and you decide that, okay, it is time for me to have more persons involved and grow the business. And there are many ways in which you can get that capital. You can get what is called ordinary capital, where persons, you are directly responsible for the profit or the loss of the company because you are a shareholder in that way. Or you could have preference shares where it is less risky, so your investors will say to you, okay, I will come into your business, but I want, it's quasi-debt, quasi-equity, I want an interest payment at a particular time. So what does it mean to list on the exchange? Having raised this money through a public offer, what it means is that company, your company, would be regulated by the Securities Act, you would be regulated by the Jamaica Stock Exchange, and you would be required to do certain things as disclosure to the market. Not everybody wants to disclose, but the literature has shown. And when I talk about literature, I'll talk about literature, and I'll talk about really what is happening now. The literature has shown that companies that are willing to disclose their business do better. There is a premium for it. Because what is happening is that if I have to disclose, I'm going to work that much harder to ensure that everything is right in my business. So it tends to have a premium. From just the fact that you are listed and you have to disclose. And what we have found in the stock exchange, you know, we have a junior market, and we have a main market. And we have found even the recent instances where these companies are listed on the junior market, we have found that their businesses have grown over 300% in terms of what they were doing. The revenues have increased, their net profit, because really what you want to look at is what is your profit. Their profits have increased significantly, and most of those companies have come back and said to us, you know, it is because of the increased governance, disclosure, putting the books in order, knowing that you are accountable to someone other than yourself, and that has really made the business grow significantly. Now, as I said before, if you want persons to access or give you money, and it is a public listing, you have to have what is called the invitation. And the invitation is nothing more than a prospectus. And the prospectus tells you what are the things that you must put, well, what are the things that you must put in that document. You must put how many shares you want to sell, the price at which it needs to be sold at. You must put a financial statement. And many persons might ask, is it possible to come to market if I've never operated a business, but I just have an idea? And it is possible. Is it possible, but it might be more difficult? Because I'm not here to tell you that there would not be more difficulty in doing that. Is it possible to come to market if my business is small? Many companies have come to market with small businesses and have grown. Again, I'm going to just raise some of the questions that people ask, that businesses ask. When I come, do I have to give everything to the public, or can I give just a small amount or so? What you need, if you are coming to the main market of the exchange, you need only offer 20% of the shares of the company to the public. That's it. Now, the other thing is, do I lose control? Now, if you offer 20% of your shares to the public, do the maths. Would you lose control? No. Right? Control for the exchange is anything over 50%. Yeah. Now, for the junior market, you only need to have 25 persons who are willing to invest in your company, and that's the minimum, and also the same 20%. Some of the things that, as I said before, governance matters. You could not come to the stock exchange if your company is not intending to be well governed. Because we have a reputation, we are there also to protect the investors. So if you have no intention of having to do that, then you could not come. So we ask you to put together things like your board of directors, your audit committee, that's the eyes that will be looking to see everything is right, and what is called a remuneration committee. We also ask that you have a mentor, and a mentor is a person who understands how to report on the issues of the business and will guide you through that process. After that is done and you have raised your money, then the listing will take place. You will supply the various documents that you see there to the exchange, and we will consider listing you. Now, what are the advantages of listing? It is an effective way of raising money. You have high profile and visibility. You must see that the persons who have come to market, the small businesses and medium businesses that have come to market, they have, you know that they are there now, because each day you might hear how their stock performed. So it provides some free advertisement that you'd not normally have if you didn't come to market. You find that many persons on the outside, globally, know that the company is listed, and as a result of that will be willing to do business with you, because the profile that you have taken on is a different profile. It is good for estate planning, but I won't go through that now. I know that we have some press for time, and it's a constant pricing. If you gave up 20% and you have the other 80, the stock is listed on the market. Almost every day you know what the price is of that stock. You can multiply what the price is by the shares that you have, and you have an idea as to the worth of the business. And for there is no transfer tax on share transfer, and if a company is listed on the junior market, that company gets 5-year tax concession. That means that you don't pay any corporate tax for 5 years. What it does, it gives the company a window to breathe and to reinvest that money in the business. However, for the junior market company, you must raise a minimum of $50 million. And that, you know, raising of that money can allow you to pay down debt, buy more machinery, etc., to make your business grow. And the next slide, as I said, when you come to market, suppose you were, there is no capital gains tax if you are to transfer those shares, sell those shares. I spoke about the 5-year corporate tax already, and there are many other benefits. The Jamaica Stock Exchange for the junior market especially reduces the fees for coming to market by 50%. Now, we have had many success stories, as I said. You cannot come to market without going through a broker. You must come to market by going through a broker. As I said, you have to have good corporate governance. And I just want to interject here that the Jamaica Stock Exchange, in association with IDB, MIF, will be providing workshops, will be providing the tools to small and medium-sized businesses to get their businesses, their books and records in order. We will come and we'll sit with you. There's a plan that will begin somewhere in June. What we are going to do is to invite small businesses, medium-sized businesses, who think that they might need to access funds from the general public, who think at some point in time they would want to list on the exchange, to come to call us, and we will work with you in terms of getting the process started. To date, we have 23 companies that are listed on the junior market. I stress the junior market, and they have raised $4.3 billion, and that's just over 5 years. What we have noticed is that job creation has gone significantly, 400 new jobs created, but in total, in terms of whether it is that's permanent jobs, jobs that are part-time, over 2,000. And two companies have recorded revenues since listing of over $1 billion. I think those are significant achievements, and just want to remind you that using equity capital, meaning that you're coming to market, you're offering part of your business to persons and they are going to give you their money, as simple as that. When you hear about equity capital, it's just that you're going to get other people's money outside that you don't know about, it's not your friends. And they are going to take a part of your business. So what is happening here, it is an efficient, low-cost method of raising capital. The clock doesn't start ticking on this money right away. It gives you the breathing space. I encourage you to look at it as an option and get involved, and we are willing to assist you in the process. Thank you.